TM4C family. TM means Texas Machines. They are designing various processing elements which are used in embedded system. Examples: TM4C123GH6PM. It is a 32-bit microcontroller. First, this TM4C family contains the ARM Cortex M-based 32-bit RISC architecture. Means it contains supporting RISC architecture, so it contains less number of instructions, support orthogonal instruction set, pipelining, Harvard architecture, less number of instructions, single and fixed length. Similarly, it supports 32-bit, indicating it can address 2 power 32 memory locations, means up to 1 GB. Next, it contains various hibernation modules to disable the unnecessary components, thereby reducing the power consumption, improving the battery backup, so avoiding the heat dissipation and improve the product life. So that is the advantage of the various hibernation modules. And it also contains multiple wake up from hibernation options. Within 1 microsecond, it will be wake up. That depends upon the processing element. Next, it supports the thumb-2 instruction set. By using thumb-2 instruction set, we have limited number of instructions, so which requires less memory, and then it can access either 16-bit code or 32-bit code. And it contains various on-chip memory devices, peripherals, and I/O ports and communication devices. So the main theme of the TM4C family is designing low power consumable by using low power modes and maximum performance by using 32-bit ARM Cortex-M architecture. So these are used in various applications like low power handheld smart devices, gaming equipment, home and commercial site monitoring control, means wherever we require a maximum performance with the low power consumption with battery cable. In all applications we can use. Examples: motion control, medical devices, means medical in the sense our auto diagnosis. Next, text and measurement equipment, our mobile phones, we require more battery backup with less power consumptions. Factory automation, fire and safety, smart energy, intelligent light control, transportation. Finally, wherever we require maximum performance and low power consumption, at that time we can use this TM4C family processing elements. So we are going to two examples. One is TM4C123GH6PM microcontroller. So if you look at this TM4C block diagram, it contains on-chip clock signal that provides the 80 MHz clock frequency for providing the clock signals. Next, it contains on-chip embedded trace macro cell for tracing the instructions and data. It contains floating point unit to perform the floating point operations. and it contains on chip nested vectored interrupt controller for efficiently utilizing the interrupts, means scheduling the interrupts, means executing a highest priority first or shortest job for scheduling by using different scheduling algorithms. Our requirement is efficiently utilizing the processor by avoiding the interrupt latencies. By using this nested vector interrupt controller, we can reduce the interrupt latency, means delay. After interrupt occurs, how much time it will take for servicing that one. That delay will be reduced by using the efficiently scheduling the interrupts. Next, memory protection unit. So if anybody unauthorizedly access the data, that will be avoided here by using this memory protection unit. Next, it contains decode bus for accessing the data, I-code bus for accessing the instructions. I means instructions, D means data, and various memory. Suppose here RAM capacity, it is containing the bootloader driver library files, advanced encryption system, cyclic redundancy check. Similarly, flash memory capacity is 256 kilobytes. Generally, this microcontroller contains on-chip processor, that is ARM Cortex M4F processor. It provides 80 MHz clock frequency. It contains some on-chip peripherals like embedded trace macro cell for tracing the instructions, floating point unit to perform floating point operations, memory protection unit to avoid the unauthorized memory accessing, nested vector interrupt controller for efficiently scheduling the interrupts and reducing the interrupt delay. Next, second part, memory devices. So it contains 32 kilobyte SRAM and 256 kilobytes flash memory, and along with that one, it contains the ROM for loading the library files, bootloader driver library files. Next, input and output ports. It contains 2 kilobytes E2 PRAM. It contains 43 pin general purpose input and output pins. Next, it contains on-chip peripherals. Those are first watchdog timer, two watchdog timers. Watchdog timer continuously monitor the system. If it is not working, it generate the reset signal. Next, direct memory access. So without CPU involving, we can transfer the data. So CPU used for required operations, so we can efficiently utilizing that one, we can avoid the wastage of CPU time. Next, it contains hibernation module, means we can disable the unnecessary devices. Like suppose if CPU is not utilizing, so we can stop the CPU. If you are not using timers, we can stop the timers. If you are not using DMA, we can stop the DMA. Automatically, whatever the power consumed by these devices will be saving, so reducing the power consumption, so reducing the heat dissipation, improving the battery life, battery backup time, like that. So we can reduce the power consumption by using hibernation modules. Automatically, we can use different wake up modules to wake up from low power mode to active mode within fraction of times based upon the processing element, that may be 1 microsecond or 5 microseconds. Next, general purpose, it contains 12 general purpose timers. So to provide the timing reference, it contains 12 bit timers. Next, it contains serial communication peripherals for transferring the data, like USB 1 Mbps data rate. Nowadays we are using USB 3.0, the latest one. Next, it contains UART asynchronous communication receiver and transmitter, I2C, inter integrated circuit, next SSI, 4 ISSI modules, serial communication interface, next CAN controller means CAN bus, 2 CAN modules to transfer the data. Next it contains 2 analog comparators, 12 bit analog digital converters, pulse width modulators and quadrature encoder interface. Next it contains joint test action group or serial wire debugging techniques for debugging the instructions. Like that, this TM4C123 GS6PM contains on-chip processing element, memory devices, I/O devices, additional peripherals and communication interfaces. Next, these are the features we are discussing now. Next, TM4C1294NCPDT microcontroller. This is also one of the microcontroller which are used in embedded systems for designing various low power consumable and maximum performance applications. It contains on-chip memory, on-chip processor, there is ARM Cortex M4F. The clock frequency is 120 MHz. Memory capacity is 1 MB, that means that is a flash memory, 1 MB flash memory, 256 kilobytes SRAM, 6 kilobytes E2 PROM, and it contains 90 general purpose input and output pins. Next, it contains various on-chip peripherals like DMA, direct memory access, watchdog timers, hibernation modules, general purpose timers, external peripheral interface, CRC, cyclic redundancy check modules, various communication devices, USB, UART, SSI, I2C, CAN and Ethernet, various on-chip peripherals, analog comparators, analog to digital converters, pulse width modulators, quadrature encoder interfaces, and on-chip debugging techniques like JTAG, serial wire debugging, on-chip oscillators for generating the clock signals, on-chip embedded trace macro cell debug the instructions, FPU, floating point unit performing the floating point operations, MPU, memory protection unit for providing the safety to the memory, avoiding the unauthorized accessing of memory, NVIC, nested vector interrupt controller. Next, instruction bus, accessing the instructions, decode bus, data bus, system bus, internet connection with the various these peripherals, ETM, FPU, NVIC, MPU, bus matrix for connecting this one, like DMA, memory, peripherals, like this. So these are the features. One second. So core ARM Cortex M4F processor. It contains 120 MHz clock frequency. It executes 150 Dystron millions of instructions per second. Its flash memory is 1 MB. SRAM capacity is 256 kilobytes, E2 PRAM 6 kilobytes, internal ROM loaded with bootloader software. It is contains external peripheral interface. Next, it contains some security modules like tamper and CRC module, to providing the security to the information. Various communication like UART, synchronous serial interface or inter-integrated circuits, CAN, Ethernets, USBs, on-chip peripherals, DMA, micro DMA, general purpose timers, watchdog timers, hibernation modules. I'll check it once.